that's a wonderful thing. It's so wonderful to see our congregation in church as well. We're gradually more and more getting used to being in church. I will just say just a few housekeeping rules, as it were, going forward, because as you know, the guidance for coming out of lockdown has been eased more. We have had a PCC meeting and done yet another risk assessment. In fact, I've done risk assessments for baptisms, funerals, weddings, general services and communion for both churches. So the rule of thumb is we are going to keep the distance between the pews because we can now sing. You can sing! I can't wait. But do wear your masks while moving. So you can have your mask off or on as you would like in the pews, but you are allowed to take them off so that you can sing if you would like. And obviously, as an ex-nurse, I'm going to continue with the hand sanitization because most germs are carried on the hands. So that is a very good thing to keep going. So we're gonna masks while moving, keep every other pew empty as we can, and what's the other one? Sanitize hands. And as we come to the communion, there may be some in the baptism party who are not used to either having communion, but you can come up for a blessing. You will see the marks on the way, as it were. We do a one-way system, coming up this way, having a communion or a blessing, and going back that way to your pews. We also have your hands extended to receive the communion by no-touch technique. I will have sanitized my hands and I give the communion by the correct method of intinction, so we can be completely confident that there is no transmission in the communion. So, it is a great welcome to you all. It is St. James's Day, which is why I'm in red and the altar is red. I'll explain a bit more about that later. And we have the baptism of Matilda, which is just such a joy to do. So first, let's give it a go and sing for all the saints.
Thank you.
of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
So let us say our prayer of preparation together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The saints were faithful unto death, and now dwell in the heavenly kingdom forever. As we celebrate their joy, let us bring to the Lord our sins and weaknesses and ask for his mercy. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So now in our baptism service books, we sing the Gloria. Without delay, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So please be seated as we have our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
The disciples determined that according to their ability, each would send relief to the believers living in Judea. This they did, sending it to the elders by Barnabas and Saul. About that time, King Herod laid violent hands upon some who belonged to the church. He had James, the brother of John, killed with the sword. This is the next word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And so now we stand to sing a hymn chosen by the family of Matilda. Tell out my soul. Let's stand and sing. She asked a favour of him. And he said to her, "What do you want?" She said to him, "Declare that these two sons of mine will sit at your right hand, one at your left in your kingdom and one at your right." But Jesus answered, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I am about to drink?" They said to him, "We are able." He said to them, "You will indeed drink my cup, but to sit at my right hand and at my left, this is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared by my Father." When the 10 heard it, they were angry at the two brothers. But Jesus called to them to him and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. It will not be so among you, but whoever wishes to be great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be your slave. Just as the Son of Man came not to be served but to serve, and gave his life a ransom for many." This is the Gospel of our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please have a seat. I've got to be honest with you, my mother's cooking was rubbish. It just was. She would put the cabbage on when she put the meat on for a Sunday roast, and by the time we got it was grey and mush. And I just could not bear it. It just made me feel sick. And she said to me, "There's thousands of children suffering in Africa. And you're wasting good food here." I questioned the good myself, but you know, I don't know if your parents said anything like that to you about the starving in Africa and don't waste things. There's some nods going on. Well, bring it forward a bit. When I'm a mother, and actually I'm quite a good cook, but we won't go there. And, you know, I'd pick the children up from school and they'd been fairly good all day in school. And I'd get them in the car or we'd be walking home, depending what the weather was like. And inevitably, a squabble would break out. You know, they'd been good all day in school and they just couldn't be good anymore, so they would just be at each other. And I'm walking with them or driving and I'm thinking, oh, crumbs. And in the end, I would lose it and I'd say, "In the bigger scheme of everything, is this important?" And again, I don't know if any of you have said that to your children, to sort of get them to sort of say, "Do you know, bickering is just not a good thing to happen." Well, in our gospel reading today, this is James the son of Zebedee and John his brother, sons of thunder. And Peter, James and John were part of Jesus' inner circle, as it were. And they were called to be with Jesus at special times, such as the transfiguration that you had last week in the service, but also the raising of the daughter of Jairus, the raising from the dead. James is mentioned before John on these occasions and may have been the elder brother. But in early chapters in the Acts of the Apostles, it is John who comes to prominence and is the companion of Peter in the works of preaching and healing. Their mum, the wife of Zebedee, seems to be a notable example of an embarrassing mother. And again, with my children, I can remember embarrassing them when we were stood in the queue of Sainsbury's, and I loved them so much that I'd be cuddling them, and they'd go, "Oh, Mum, get away." So here we have the wife of Zebedee putting forward her children, drawing attention to her special wishes for her precious sons. However, the brothers are ready to accept her intervention and to respond confidently to the challenging question which Jesus puts to them. It was not for nothing that Jesus had earlier called them the sons of Boanerges, the sons of thunder, because they were forthright, they were ambitious, they thought they could do it. They do not know yet that the baptism that they are to share with Jesus is the baptism of innocent blood, and that the cup is not only the cup of salvation, but also the cup of death. Then the other 10 join in the discussion, indignant that these two should have been singled out. It's like my two in the car on the way home. They're going at each other, what do you mean? In fact, it is a very human situation, all this, escalating from family pride to a general falling out. The whole group needed to be called together and reminded that the values of God's kingdom are not the values of this world. Jesus had given them the supreme example of humility and service. As we come to know Jesus and know that being with Jesus means that sometimes God needs to box our heads together. That's what my mother used to say. I'm going to box your heads together if you two don't behave. Sometimes Jesus needs to give us that truth about his very being. And as we come to understand what being a disciple of Christ means, we come to know that being with Jesus means that we must lose ourselves and not be selfish. On the picture for the gospel, it was Mahatma Gandhi who said the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. And in our gospel today, Jesus said the greatest among you must be your servant. Then he said it to the disciples. A bit later on, he said it to the scribes and Pharisees as well in Matthew 23, verse 11. Learning to lose ourselves is a difficult thing. There is another story as well, is that when the disciples went out, they wore their sandals down. When you look at the picture on the screen, you've got a very good shoe that's barely worn, and you've got another shoe that is almost worn out. We need to wear out our shoes by getting out there together now, safely, of course. We're all a bit nervous, and even having a baptism in church with a congregation, this is a first, I pray, of many. But I pray also it is the first where we come to know Jesus in the presence of Jesus who loves us all. When we understand that Jesus is the one who has taken the cup, who has gone through the gateway of death and out the side, we can always have confidence that as we go through the sufferings and pains and difficulties of life, and even through the gateway of death, we are safe because Jesus is there to guide us through. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And that's why baptizing Matilda today is so important, because it gives her the confidence to be alive, be living, go for things, a bit like the Sons of Thunder. Have that confidence, have that ambition to go through life and know that Jesus Christ has gone through it himself. He leads our way. And so today we will be bringing her into the kingdom of God, which is such a joy. It does make us think about the abundance of God in giving us each other, in giving us life, and not just life, but because Jesus went through the gateway of death, he brings us and shows us eternal life, life beyond us, the bigger picture. So we can tell out our souls the greatness of the Lord, whose unnumbered blessings, whose abundance of life can give our spirit voice, so that we can make known God's might and only in Jesus Christ. The point of this is not just to say, yeah, great, I've accepted it. It's to actually get our shoes wearing out so that, as the Tell Out My Soul song goes on, proud hearts and stubborn self-wills can be put to flight so that the hungry are fed, the homeless are homed, and the helpless are helped. The countless gifts of love that God gives us the bigger picture of the total abundance of God's giving. And this knowledge guides us when we are perplexed, as it frees us from the ills of this world and the fear of death itself. Today, my brothers and sisters, is a glorious day where true greatness lies in thankfulness and humble service, because following Jesus is the highest of privileges. It can be costly and demanding, but actually it is the greatest joy that we can have, and it is that joy that we pass on to Matilda now. So, I ask that you stand and turn towards the font, please. Matilda, may God, who has received you by baptism into his church, pour upon you the riches of his grace, that within the company of Christ's pilgrim people you may daily be renewed by his anointing spirit and come to the inheritance of the saints in glory. Amen. Lord God, we thank you that you have claimed for yourself Matilda, who has been washed in the waters of rebirth. Uphold her in this new life, that she may remain ever steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and rooted in your life, love. Father of life, make known your glory. Pour your blessing upon all your people. May our hearts ever praise you and find their perfect rest in you. Grant us the freedom of your service and perfect peace in doing your will. Father of life, make known your glory. The whole creation is filled with the light of your grace. Dispel any darkness in our hearts. Forgive our sins and negligences, that we may come at last to the light of your eternal glory. Father of life, make known your glory. God of grace and life, in your love, you have given us a place among your people. Keep us all faithful to our baptism and prepare us for that glorious day when the whole creation will be made perfect in your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, in whom we make all our prayers. Amen. And so now, in utter joyfulness, let us stand to sing. Now thank we all our God with hearts and hands and voices. faces turned towards your word. In love, you gave us Jesus Christ, your Son, to rescue us from sin and death. Your word goes out to call us home, to the city where angels sing your praise. We join with them in heaven's song. Jesus came as your light, with signs of faith and words of hope. He touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean. This is his story. This is our song, Hosanna in the highest. The crowds came out to see your son, yet at the end they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people. This is his story.
This is our song, Hosanna in the highest.
Jesus blessed you, Father, for the food. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body given for you all." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, gave it, and said, "This is my blood, shed for you all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." This is his story.
This is our song, Hosanna in the highest.
Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which he died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again and is alive with you to plead for us and all the world. This is our story.
This is our song, Hosanna in the highest.
Send your Holy Spirit on us now, that by these gifts we may feed on Christ with opened eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, where all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. And so let us say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one body.
remind you, in coming up for communion, wear your masks, hold your hands out at arm's length, and I will give you the communion by no touch technique. Hold on to the communion till you get back to your seats, and then take your communion. I will give communion to the choir first. If you're not used to having communion, God's blessing is on you as well, so come up for a blessing, because the abundance of God is never ending. It is infinite, as is his love. So come on up. Let us pray. Lord God, the source of truth and love, keep us faithful to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, united in prayer and in the breaking of bread, and one in joy and simplicity of heart. Amen. And so let us say our post-communion prayer together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer us, you our souls and bodies, to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. So let us stand to sing our final hymn, O Jesus, I have promised to serve thee to the end. We have an Alpha course starting on Monday the 6th of September, and this is for all who have questions or want to learn more about life and the Christian faith. We will be in St. Mary's Hall from 7 till 9. We will give you a meal, and it will be a time of real exploration and enjoying learning. So do contact myself or John Savage here, are to book at alpha@frenchandchurches.org.uk. And another, it's not exactly breaking news because I mentioned it the other week, but the Archbishop of Canterbury is coming, and I thank John Hetherington, who doesn't know what he's let himself in for, I don't think, but the Archbishop of Canterbury is coming to Moorhouse School, and the point of that is to for villagers and people from the Deanery of Farnham to come. There's a capacity of 500 people, and he is going to give his message, which is asking the big questions. So, you know, making an opportunity to ask questions. So if you want to ask him a question, you can do it through me, if you would like. There's a poster outside. To book a place, you have to go on the web and go on Eventbrite. But I will let you know that that is mainly for people who, if you like, are friends of church people who don't perhaps come to church. On the Friday night, there is a special evening with the Archbishop for all church people, for 5,000 people at Lakeside in Camberley. And again, to book that, contact me. But if lots want to go from the church to the Friday evening, perhaps I'll book a coach, might do that, because that would be perhaps easier. This so Moorhouse School is on the 26th of September, the Friday evening is the 24th of September. As the 26th is a Sunday, there won't be a 10:30 service here. We'll be helping John and getting set up and all those sorts of things. So any questions, do see me, as it were. So, will you please stand? The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
God give you grace to follow his saints in faith and hope and love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
During this difficult time when our church buildings are closed, we're still a church. meeting virtually for prayer services and fellowship, loving our neighbours by offering practical support to the vulnerable, and caring for our communities. The work of our church is reliant on people's generosity, a generosity that is a hallmark of a lived-out faith and a testament to it. We give to our church in a variety of ways, but with the closure of all our buildings, we cannot receive all the gifts that we usually would. So we really need your help now.